下午的聚会第一节是见证会。
This afternoon's first session will have a testimony session.
我们很难得请到黄传道来跟我们见证我生命的恩惠。
It is very a rare opportunity that we have the chance to invite Pastor Huang to testify for us the grace in my life.
在见证会的开始，我们先一起跪下祷告，求神开启我们属灵的眼睛，能够听出这里面生命的恩惠跟我们的生命有什么关系。
And before the testimony session, we're going to kneel down and pray, and to God, ask God to open up our ears so we may understand how His life's grace can edify ours.
一起祷告。
Let's pray in court.
奉主耶稣圣名做见证。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I come to testify.
教会负责人说我要离开这里了。
The council members tells me that I am about to leave here,
Owen Park Church. 所以一定要做见证。
That I have to testify.
我说我见证都做过了、
啊、And I tell them that I already testify so much.
他说不完整了、哦、
And then they tell me that your testimony is not yet complete.
所以如果你听过小弟的见证，这堂课可以安息一下。
And so if you have heard my testimony before, then maybe this is a session that you can take some time to rest.
在奉主耶稣圣名做见证。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I testify.
在这边数算主耶稣的恩惠。
Here I count the blessings of God.
尤其在移民到今天这段日子。
Especially since I immigrated to the United States till today.
我分几段来讲。
I will separate this time period into different sessions.
讲不完，下次再讲。
And if I cannot finish, then I will take another session to finish it.
来谈一谈小弟在求学时代的恩惠。
I will first talk to share with you the grace that I received while I was studying.
在工作上面的恩惠。
The grace that I received when I was working.
我们家人从神所领受的恩惠。
And the blessings my family received from God.
在这个经济上神的一个带领。
And financially how God has guided us.
最后谈一谈当传道人的感想。
And then lastly, I would like to share with you my reflections as pastor.
小弟是1985年一个人来到美国留学。
I came to the United States to study abroad in 1985.
在美国没有亲戚朋友。
In the United States, I do not have any relatives nor family members.
所以那一段是很值得令人回忆的一段时间。
So it is a time period that I often look back and think about it.
当时选择学校就是哪里便宜哪里去。
So in the beginning when I chose school, I chose the one that has the lowest tuition.
路易斯安那州最便宜。
The state of Louisiana had offered me the lowest tuition.
不晓得你们没有听过这个州。
I don't know if you even ever heard of the state.
这在美国的南部。
And this is in the southern part of the United States.
你们不知道也好，因为那里真的鸟不下蛋。
It's probably you don't know it because it's a state that nothing much goes on there.
当时啊，来美国的第一个印象就是什么都很大。
And the first impression when I first came to the United States was everything was so big.
大家都开好大的车子。
Everyone drives big cars.
大家都住很大的房子。
Everyone lives in big homes.
其实留学这段时间呢，可以说是我人生一个受苦的一个开始。
But the period when I started studying abroad, it was also the beginning of my sufferings.
我记得第一天下飞机啊。
I remember the first day when I landed.
大家都很累。
Everyone was very tired.
因为跟台湾一些朋友一起到Southwest Louisiana 那个大学青年署。
And together with a couple of other friends, we went to Southwest Louisiana.
那肚子就饿了，下飞机很累，肚子也很饿。
So we landed and we were very hungry.
我就想说要开罐头来吃。
So I thought of probably buying some food cans to.
那是从台湾带来的。
And those were brought all the way from Taiwan.
结果这个不太会用他们的工具。
But I did not know how to use their tools.
所以开一半那个罐头开不开，真的有点笨。
And halfway through opening the can, I realized that I can no longer open it.
那开不开，肚子很饿，所以就用手去搬了。
And because I was very hungry and I don't know how to open the can, so I used my finger to open.
结果一不小心用一扳啊，把这个手指头都割进去了。
And without being very careful, the can actually went through my finger.
其实你会是一个小事情啊。
Maybe you think that this is something just rather small.
但是那次真的割得很深，因为到现在还留下一个横疤。
And it was very, the cut was so deep that even till today you can see the scar.
我可以感觉到你心脏跳一下，那个血就跟着喷一下，这样。
And you can feel that every bump of my heart, I can feel the blood flowing out through the fingers.
他们要带我去医院呢。
They wanted to take me to the hospital.
可是我不敢去。
But I was afraid to go to the
hospital. 刚到美国没有保险呢。
Because I just came, I didn't have insurance.
所以我曾听说这个要花很多钱。
And I heard that going to the hospital will spend a lot of money.
所以边按着边祷告。
So I pressed my wounds and I started praying.
这个就是我留学的一个第一天的一个灾难呢。
And this is the first tribulation and encounter my first day here in the United States.
其实这样就跟着下来了。
And following that came many more.
这个一个人到国外哦，刚开始什么都很困难。
As being here alone, everything seems very difficult.
本来刚开始住校嘛，跟同就是住在学校。
I lived on campus.
住校那个吃也住在在那个 cafeteria 就吃学校。
And I would eat in the campus cafeteria.
我们几个同学都会开玩笑说，哎，我们在这边要来消耗美国的国力啊，所以就尽量吃啊，反正付同样的钱。
And we would joke around between my friends and say, since everything is one price, then we would just eat as much as we can.
我当时看到那个咖啡是免费的。
And I saw how the coffee was free.
我很喜欢喝咖啡啊。
And I really like drinking coffee.
在台湾咖啡很贵。
Because in Taiwan, coffee was expensive.
所以就拼命喝咖啡啊。
So I started drinking a lot of coffee.
哇，可是喝咖啡有个问题，就是晚上睡不着觉。
But there's a problem for drinking so much coffee. It's like I cannot fall asleep at night.
那白天哦，因为英文也不太行啊，所以白天听不懂老师在讲什么。
And in the morning, because I just came, my English isn't that fluent, so I didn't quite understand what the professor was talking about.
所以哦，一听到老师上课，听一听，是很认真的，两个眼睛瞪着他看这样子。
And in the morning, I would pay so much attention that my eyes were wide open, looking straight in the professor.
后来就想起台湾的一句俗语，他说啊，听雷啦，就是鸭子听雷啊，就是这样一直听，听不懂在讲什么。
And that reminds me of how there's a Chinese saying that it's like ducks listening to human talk, and you just wonder and still not understand.
那听不懂就开始打瞌睡。
And because I didn't understand, I started falling asleep.
因为晚上又没有睡好，所以开始牙龈也肿了。
And because I didn't have much sleep at night, therefore my gum started
infection.
And you know that even though toothache is not really any big illness, but it's quite painful.
所以我知道留学真的很辛苦啊。
So I started realizing that studying abroad is very difficult.
所以我以前说过，我晚上睡觉的时候都会想起台湾的情形，因为很想家。
And because I miss home so much at night, I will often reflect back on my life in Taiwan.
真的是会想到那个家里那个小霸掌哦，十二点了哦，小霸掌来了哦，小霸掌都会听到那个想象那个声音呢。
And especially at midnight, I would start imagination of how the street vendor will cross by my door and start selling stuff.
那因为上课听不懂。
And because I didn't understand in class.
考试就不会。
And of course, I do not know how to take the test. And I wanted to cheat.
但是不敢作弊啊。
But I was afraid to cheat.
我是基督徒，不可以作弊啊。
Because I'm a Christian, I'm not allowed to cheat.
可是就是写不出来。
But I really don't know how to take the test.
后来考卷发下来。
And then later, when they return our test back to us,
二十几分呢。
I only scored 20-some.
我这辈子从来没有考这么烂的试过，真的。
Throughout my life, I never got such a low score.
我说这完蛋了，真的是没有办法毕业了，不知道怎么办。
And I thought to myself, I'm doomed. I probably would not ever graduate.
所以精神上也很痛苦啊。
So I was very painful mentally.
那我们知道基督徒就是有痛苦就祷告神呢。
And we know as Christians, whenever we are stressed and we're frustrated, we pray to God.
那我那时候读研究所的课。
And I was taking my graduate classes.
那没有 B 就没有办法毕业。
So if I don't end up with a B, then I cannot graduate.
我就祷告神神啊，拜托拜托，这怎么办呢？这很难拿 B 啦，这怎么办呢
？So I pray to God and I ask God, what should I do?
后来真的很奇妙。
A miraculously.
期末考之前，老师这样讲。
Before the final exam, the professor told us.
他说你们有同学去那个系主任那边告状啊。
He said that some of you went to the department head to complain.
他说我不会教了。
That I don't know how to teach you guys.
所以我决定给你们每个人都 pass, 都拿 B 啊。
So I decided that I will give you all a passing grade.
啊，但是我会私下给你一封信呢。如果你不及格，我会给你一封信呢。
But if you fail, then I will give you a letter personally.
啊，你拿到之后呢，希望你下学期重新拿一次。
And if you do receive such letter, I ask you to retake my class.
我真的收到那一封信呢。
And I was one that received such letter.
但是我没有重新拿他的课。
But I did not retake his class.
所以就是觉得很辛苦啊。
It was very difficult for me.
你知道一个人在国外一年没有出校园，真的是很辛苦的事情。
Do you know how difficult it is for someone not to leave campus for a whole year?
大概只有出去一次了哈。
I only went out once.
那是有爱心的那个中国同学会办的。
And it was assigned by the Chinese Fellowship on campus.
你知道我们基督徒哦，很喜欢敬拜神。
You know that as Christian, we love to worship God.
但是那里又没有真耶稣教会。
But there's no True Jesus Church there.
Lafayette, Louisiana, 离那个 Houston Church 大概要四个小时的车程。
I was studying in Lafayette, Louisiana, and it was 4 hours from the nearest church.
没有办法去聚会。
I was unable to go to attend service.
怎么办嘛？解决心灵的需要呢？
How do I quench my thirst?
我就去外教会聚会。
So I went to other denominations.
但是实在是不太习惯。
But I was not getting used to it.
两点很不习惯。
There were two things I wasn't quite used to.
第一点就是他们牧师才太好了，实在是很不习惯。
First is that their pastor was very eloquent.
我说，你这个我知道，只有一个教会是我认定的啊，为什么你们这个教会怎么讲得这么好呢？不太习惯。
In my heart, I thought to myself, there's only one church that I will acknowledge, but how come you speak with such eloquence?
那问题是哦，口才好哦，那个80%都好棒的道理，那个最重要的通通是跟我感觉不一样的，都是我认为不对的。
And the problem is 80% of the sermon is very good, but the 20% in which is the truth, I cannot quite acknowledge with it.
那另外一个不习惯。
And there was another point that I wasn't quite.
就是他们聚会会传那个奉献袋。
Is that during the sermon they will pass an offering bag?
那你知道我是基督徒，我应该要奉献啊。
You know I'm a Christian and I know that I need to make offering.
啊，但是我很穷啊。
But I was very poor.
所以我每次奉献袋传到我的手上，我就很挣扎。
So every time when they pass the offering bag to me, I struggle.
我想放一块钱进去哈，找75%出来了。
I even thought that I would put a dollar in and take 3/4 back.
可是哦，我不好意思手伸进去。
But I feel ashamed to put my fingers inside that offering bag.
所以我就传给隔壁啊。
So I just passed on the bag.
想不到听到你在5分钟又传回来了。
But then 5 minutes later, they passed the bag back to me.
很不习惯了。
I was very uneasy at that.
后来我就决定不去那个教会聚会。
So I decided to stop going to that church.
啊，没有人聚会怎么办呢？我喜欢聚会啊。
But if I have no church to attend service, then what should I do? Because I like attending service.
后来我想，我找个伴来一起读经吧。
So I thought to find a companion that probably can have Bible study.
没有伴啊，去哪里找伴呢
？But where can I find a companion?
Louisiana 很多那个池塘哈，很多那个 swamp 哈，里面有乌龟了。
And in Louisiana, the school has a lot of ponds, and there's many turtles.
我说我去找乌龟读圣经。
So I decided to go and look for a turtle to have Bible study.
我去读圣经给乌龟听了。
I will read the Bible to the turtle.
结果我去池塘那边读圣经给乌龟听，我真的去啊。
So I truly went to the pond and started reading Bible to the turtle.
乌龟不理我。
The turtle ignored me.
跑到池塘下面去了。
And still went back to his pond.
所以心灵很寂寞。
So I was very lonesome.
在那时候晚上睡觉，常常会想起"三更有梦书当枕，千里怀人夜在风"了。就是哦，就是啊，这个又想起故乡了，就是很寂寞。
So at night, I often think of the situations back home.
啊，那功课又不好啊。
And I was bad at school.
啊，每次打电话回家就很想跟爸爸讲："爸，我要回家了，我不玩了。"
And every time calling back home, I wanted to tell my father that I want to go back home. I don't want to study here anymore.
但是讲不出口哎。
But I couldn't say those words.
我爸实在花太多钱给我来国外了。
Because my father spent a lot of money to send me to study abroad.
那怎么办呢？身体也不好，精神也不好，信仰也不好。
What should I do? I was weak in faith. I was weak in health. I was weak at school.
你知道这个一年来没有教会哦，这个灵性一直软弱下去。
And a year without church, my faith continued to weaken.
我再这样下去，我会失去我的灵命啊。
And I know that if I continue like this, I will lose my spirituality.
有一天我读圣经。
And one day when I was studying the Bible,
我读到雅歌第一篇，我们看雅歌。
Let's turn to the book of Song of Solomon.
雅歌第一篇。
Song of Songs.
第八节。
Chapter 1, verse 8.
第一章第八节。
Song of Songs, chapter 1, verse 8.
一章八节。
Chapter 1, verse 8.
你这女子中极美丽的，你若不知道，只管跟随羊群的脚中去，把你的山羊羔牧放在牧人帐篷的旁边。我读这一节很感动。
I was deeply moved by this verse.
我真的不晓得怎么办。
I didn't know what to do.
他说，如果你不知道，只管跟随羊群的脚中去。
And here says that if you do not know, follow the tracks of the sheep.
那我感动就是说，神要让我去一个有真耶稣教会的地方啊。
And I was moved because I know God is telling me to go to a place that has two Jesus Church.
何必把你的山羊羔放在这个牧人帐篷旁边哦？就是不要在外教会的这些牧人的旁边哦，不要在这里啦。
And God is telling me not to be next to the tents of the shepherds.
啊，所以我就很挣扎，因为一转学，很多学分就会失去。
But I struggle because if I decide to transfer, I will lose many of the credits.
但是不转学，我可能会没有灵性。
But if I don't transfer, then I may lose my spirituality.
因为信仰很低潮啊。
Because I was the lowest point of my faith.
后来决定啊，算了，那个生命比钱重要了。
And then later I thought, the spirituality is more important than money.
所以第二学年我就转到纽约去。
So the second, second year, I transferred to New York.
我立志啊，每天晚上，就是有聚会的时间，我从来不要缺席。
And I made a determination that every time there's a service, I would not miss.
发觉到我亲近神哦，发觉到神的恩惠一直的临到我身上。
I realized that I decided to get close to God, and the blessings of God continue to pour upon me.
哦，真的，我很多很意外的恩典呐。
I had many blessings.
你知道，在一个国留学生在国外，其实发挥最贵的就是主。
We know that as a student from abroad, the most of the expenses are spent on living.
食衣住行哈，食不很贵嘛哈，衣
反正都穿旧的嘛哈，
住最贵，行最贵了。
Food is usually not expensive. Clothing, I can wear old clothes, but the most expensive is usually transportation and living.
那我到纽约去啊，第一次亲近神，就很多奇妙的事情发生。
When I decided to go to New York to get close to God, many miraculously things happened.
就让我想起以前要出国之前那个林凤来长老在神训班勉励我们说，你们通通要国外去留学。
It reminded me that before I left Taiwan, Elder Lin encouraged all the students.That you should go and study abroad.
我跟长老举手，跟长老讲说，长老我要去啊，但是没钱怎么办
？And I often would raise my hand and said, Elder Lin, I would love to go, but I don't have any money.
那林长老讲说，你放心啦，一出去哦，神就会从天上掉下钱来给你了。
But he will encourage us that don't worry when if you decide to go, then God will bring money from above.
我心中就说阿门。
And I would say Amen.
那我真的就这样出来了。
Indeed, like this, I left Taiwan.
这样的一个对话实现在纽约市。
And this conversation took place once again in my life.
小弟住在纽约市，为了省钱住在一个地下室。
Because to save money, I live in the basement.
有四个房间。
There were four rooms in the basement.
都是租给学生。
And they were rented out to students.
住了一段时间，房东说我不用付钱了。
And after a time period, the owner of the house told us that I no longer need to pay rent.
我说为什么？
And I asked him why.
他说你以后帮我收房租就可以了。
He told me that you only be responsible collecting rent.
我真的很感谢主嘞。
And I was thankful to God.
我真的不用付房租嘞。
I don't have to pay any rent.
他后来补充一句说，那个我的家的草地你也顺便帮我割一割哈。
And then he even told me that how about you help me do my gardening job?
我说可以啊，那你要付我多少钱呢？
And I said, for sure, of course I can do your garden job, but how much are you willing to pay me?
付你50块钱一个月。
And then he said, how about $50 a month?
我说 no problem.
And I said to him, no problem.
就是这样子。
And like this.
我就在留学时代不用付房租直到毕业。
I didn't need to pay any rent till I graduated.
那除了之外呢，后来因为常常上教会都要搭 subway 啦，搭 bus 啦，要大概有2个小时左右。
And on top of that, because I need to get on mass transportation to go to church.
要两个小时啊。
About 2 hours, right?
然后来我在打工，就想要买一辆车啊。
And because I was only working part-time, I wanted to buy my own car.
因为在美国没有车，等于没有脚，很不方便。
Because in the States, without a car means you don't have any legs.
后来教会有一个同龄打电话过来。
One day, a brother or called me.
那黄弟兄，黄弟兄，你要不要一辆车子？要不要一辆免费的车子？
And then he asked me, Brother Huang, do you want a free car?
我说天下哪有那么好的事情啊。
And I asked myself, how come there's, you know, I never heard of such thing.
他说有人要送教会一辆车了，教会不需要了，所以他送给教的时候就送给你了，好不好？
And the brother said, because someone wants to donate a car to church, but the church doesn't need it, so when they give it to church, the church will give it to you.
我当然说哪有什么不好的，当然好啊。
And I said to him, of course, that's nice.
但是后来他们说不送了啦。
But then they told me that they decided not to give me the car.
送给你，他不能省税啊，送给教会才能省税啊，教会又不要，又不能作假，所以送给你他不要。哎、
And he said that because if they give it to church, then it's tax deductible. But if they give it to you as a personal gift, it's not tax deductible.
我说没有关系啦，你问他要卖多少钱呢、啊？
And later I said, it's okay. Well, how about if, how much does he want to sell it?
反正我在打工嘛。
And because I already is working part time.
结果他决定卖我多少钱呢？
And do you know how much he decided to sell me?
卖我一块钱美金。
He sold it to me for $1.
但是我就觉得说，哇，真的主耶稣真的很恩待我。
I truly feel how God has blessed me.
后来功课有神的帮助也比较好。
And later, my school, with the help of God, I was getting better.
也可以拿到奖学金。
I was able to get scholarship.
这个都是主耶稣的恩惠，因为我念书不是那么好的。
And this all is the blessings of God because I'm not as good academically.
那后来大学毕业，本来念研究所，后来跳到大学去读啊。大学毕业后来研究所也毕业了。
Later I graduated from both college and grad school.
那要找工作。
I started looking for a job.
那可是你知道那时候没有绿卡。
And but back then I didn't have a legal status.
所以他们说找工作很难呢、啊。
So they told me that would make my career hunt even harder.
他们说、哦、你要找工作、哦、要像这个扫机关枪一样、哦、一直送 resume 履历表这样送机关枪这样一直送。
They told me that to look for a job, you have to send out your resume as mass as of a amount as possible.
可是我真的很奇妙呢。
But it was very miraculous.
我们一个弟兄要找工作。
There was a brother was also looking for a job.
他说他没有车子。
And he told me that he didn't have a ride.
问我可不可以带他去面谈。
He asked me whether I can take him to the interview site.
我说没有问题啊，这辆车是神的。
And I said, of course, because this car belongs to God.
所以我就答应带他去一个很远的地方面谈了。
So I promised him, and I took him to the interview site, which is very far.
后来他觉得不好意思了，顺便问他老板说：“哎，我有一个朋友也在找工作，要不要一起请他来面谈呢？”
And because the brother felt quite bad about asking me for such a long drive, so he even asked the interviewers that I have a friend looking for a job. Do you also want to interview him?
所以我真的没有送出一份履历表，我履历表带在我的口袋里面。
But I didn't even had a chance to submit even one resume. My resume was still in my pocket.
我就这样找到第一份这个写程式的工作。
And like this, I found my first job as a programmer.
所以觉得主耶稣哦，真的很爱人呐、啊。
I feel that God truly loves man.
这个工作做了两年。
This job lasted 2 years.
那快要办身份，快要办到身份了。
And it was to the point that I was about to get my legal status.
那我也是很大胆啊，因为想说主耶稣在我身旁嘛。
Of course, I was very daring because I thought God was next to me.
所以找到第一份正式的工作，我就买一个新房子。
So when I found my first job, I bought a home.
那时候女儿生了，也生了一个新儿子。
And I had my son.
然后这个买了一辆新车子。
And I also bought a new car.
所以就有反正就是一般就是都会这样做嘛。
This will be done by any other normal person.
那我岳父岳母又来我们家给我们坐月子。
And my father and my mother-in-law, they both came to live with us.
我绿卡还没有办到哦，快要办到了。
But at that time, I didn't have my green card yet. I was about to get my green card.
那个公司开始裁员了。
But they started laying off at the company I was in.
第一波没有裁到我。
The first wave, I was not laid off.
第二波没有裁到我。
The second wave, I was not laid off.
第三波我被叫进去了。
But the third wave came and I was called in.
真的脸都绿了，没有骗你啊。
I was not kidding you. My face turned white.
怎么没有想到怎么会这样子？
I didn't ever thought that this would happen to me.
他叫我们 pack 啦，东西收一收，啊，有人会陪我们出去啊。
And they asked me to pack my stuff, and someone will accompany and walk me out.
你知道那个时候很多人都心情很不好，如果他没有人陪哦，你会乱打破这个，会有的人就是很不好，就是会乱来。
Because they feel that for those people who are laid off, they may be destructive due to the unhappiness that they got laid off.
啊，心情真的很不好啊。
But I was I was feeling very bad.
回去老婆就问，哎，今天怎么心情那么难看？怎么一刀大包小包往里面扛啊？
And I went home. My wife asked me, "How come? What happened to you today? How come you're not? You don't look so good, and you brought home so much stuff."
我说，哎呀，不要问，不要问。
And I told my wife, "Don't ask."
然后换我岳父问了，啊，今天怎么那么早回家啊？
And then my father-in-law asked, "How come you're home so early today?"
不知道怎么回答嘞。
I don't know how to answer.
他说：“爸爸，没事，从现在开始，我有很多时间陪你出去玩。”
And I said to my father-in-law, "Don't worry, everything is fine. Right now, I have plenty of time to accompany you."
嘴巴这样讲啊。
Even though I said this,
心中很难过。
But in my heart, I was sad.
我真的没有骗你，晚上开始睡不着觉。
And at night, I couldn't fall asleep.
因为车子是贷款的啊。
Because I had payments on my car.
房子是贷款的啊。
I had payments for my house.
啊。儿子生下来要没有保险啊。
And my son was just born, so he has no insurance.
那怎么办呢？
What should I do?
所以晚上睡觉真的睡不着觉。
So at night, I really couldn't fall asleep.
没有骗我，常常想到一个图画，就是哦，那个有一个鸟巢哦，啊，三只鸟啊，嘴巴张大，要吃要吃要吃，啊，没有人给他东西吃，这样子。
And I often have this image that I see a nest with three birds and keep opening up their mouths like crying, "I want to eat, I want to eat," but there's nothing to eat.
啊，不晓得怎么样，一个传道突然来访问我。
But I don't know how, but a pastor came and visited me.
哎，我就跟他讲，偷偷的跟他讲。
And I secretly told him.
啊，拜托帮忙祷告一下。
I said, "Please pray for me."
没工作啦。
Because I don't have a job.
哎，那个传道真的帮我按手祷告啊。
The pastor laid hands on me and prayed for me.
真的很奇妙嘞。
Miraculously,
我心真的开了。
My heart was open.
真的开了。
Really open up.
有两个观念进到心里面来。
Because there are two messages that came across.
第一个观念呢。
First message.
经上讲，义人的后代不会当乞丐啊。
Is that the descendants of a righteous man will never be beggars?
哎，我爸爸是义人，我不会当乞丐。
My father is a righteous man, so I will not be a beggar.
啊，第二个，我妈妈说一根草一点露。
My mother said a grass.
一枝草一点露啦，一根草一点露啦。其实你仔细看，一根草有很多露，不止一点露啦。
My mother said that on a grass you will find a morning dew, and we know that on a grass you will not only find one dew.
我真的是很放心呢。
So I was very relieved.
啊，反正有时间玩再说啦。
So I told myself, since I have time, let's take a we'll travel.
所以万一你真的没有工作哈，你真的要好好玩，我没有骗你，因为再来哈，工作就很多了，没有骗你哦。
So if you don't have a job, take that time to enjoy yourselves because once you have a job, you have no more time.
我真的带我岳父到处玩啊。
I took my father-in-law and we traveled.
真的心开了就好好玩嘛，对不对？
Since my heart opened up, so we decided to travel.
玩回来之后，
after we returned from
公司打电话给我，
my company called me.
说对不起，我们猜错人了。
And my company said to me, we want to apologize. We laid off the wrong
person. 你要不要再回来上班？
Do you want to come back?
我说，那你遣散费要不要拿回去？他给我一大堆遣散费啊。
And I asked him, "Well, would you do you want to take back the severance package?"
哦，不用了，你留着啦。
And he told me, "No, just keep the severance package."
真的呢，我赚了十天的假期，两个口袋满满的钱，玩了十天，回来又回到现在的工作上班了。
And I'm not, I wasn't joking. I took a 10-day severance, so I went to travel for 10 days. I came back, and the job is there waiting for me.
那其实更宝贵的就是我心中。发觉到有主耶稣真的有平安，有祷告真的有平安，那个才是宝贵的。
But the most precious is I realized that in my heart, if I have Jesus Christ, then there's peace.
那后来我知道这家公司也真的不行了。
Later I realized that truly this company wasn't doing so good.
后来我不等，我就他请我回去，我回去一下我就把他裁了，下次换我裁他了。
So I did return to my job, but for a little while I decided to quit.
因为有一家很好的公司，一家药厂请我去上班。
Because there was another pharmaceutical company that wanted to hire me.
感谢主了，我就在那一家拿到绿卡。
And thank God there, I also received my green card.
所以这是在工作上的恩惠。
So these are the blessings in terms of my career.
主要就是我觉得工作常常会换，但是心情主要是会保守。
I know that jobs we can often change, but our heart will be preserved by Jesus.
我再谈一谈我们家里很多的恩惠。
Now I would like to talk about the grace in my family.
我们这个神真的是又真又活的神。
Our God is a true and living God.
我们有遇到困难。
When we encounter problems,
他真的会保守。
He will keep us.
我相信很多人在这都在座的都很多人开车啊。
I know that many of you drive here.
这个开车子哦很好，但是也很麻烦。
Driving is good, but it can be quite troublesome sometimes.
这个有时候常常会发生车祸。
Because you might get into accidents.
有一次我太太，我们住在 New Jersey, Persephone 的时候。
When I was still living in New Jersey,
我太太拿垃圾出去倒。
My wife took the trash out.
突然之间隔壁的人 来敲门。
And suddenly the next door neighbor came and knocking our door.
说我太太出问题了。
They said he came and told me that my wife is in trouble.
我出去一看，我太太躺在那里在哭啊。
I went out and I saw that my wife was laying on the floor crying.
你知道怎么回事吗？
Do you know what happened?
在那个下雨的傍晚，晚上快要傍晚的时候。
That night, when rained a lot.
有一个人 back up 他的车子。
There was a man that backed up his car.
暗暗的没有看到车子在那边，我没有看到我太太在走路，就在 dumpster 的前面，没有看到她在走。
And because it was so dark, he didn't see my wife passing behind him.
他就把他 knock down.
And the car knocked my wife down.
然后 run, 那个轮胎应该是到这里来了。
And the wheels came all the way to her shoulder.
啊，那个人哦，把他 knock down 还不知道撞到人呢。
And they knocked her down, but not unknowingly, knowing that they already knocked someone down.
所以真的很感谢神呢。
So really, thank God.
我们送到急诊去。
I took her to the emergency room.
X 光出来，什么都没有断。
They took the X-ray and nothing broke.
但是我们就觉得说，哦，真的有时候，那个人世间如果不是神保守，什么事情都可以发生。
So I truly feel that if it's not for the perseverance of God, then anything can happen.
圣经上讲，万事互相效力，叫爱神的人得益处。
So everything is benefits itself for those who love God.
啊，有一次也是跟车子有关系啊。
And one time, something else to do with a car.
我记得很清楚，那是我跟着啊梁德仁传道去非洲。
I remember that time I went on the missionary trip with Pastor Lee.
那是我第一次去非洲啊。
And that is my first time traveling to Africa.
那我们早上都会祷告一段时间再出门。
So in the morning, we often will pray for some time before we leave.
那次祷告很奇妙。
And in that prayer was very miraculous.
一直一个声音一直跟我讲，为你的太太跟儿子祷告，他们要出车祸了。
And there was a voice that kept telling me that pray for your wife and your son, they're about to get into an accident.
我在非洲的丛林里面，怎么会这个声音一直进来说要为你太太跟儿子祷告，他们要出车祸了？
And I kept wondering, I'm in the mid of Africa jungle, but how come this voice keep telling me this message?
我就听这个声音，我就为我的孩子跟太太祷告。
And following this voice, I pray for my wife and my son.
我真的不晓得怎么回事啊。
I really didn't know what was going
on. 后来回到北加州，那时候我在北加州。
After I returned to Northern California,
我太太开车过来，我看车子没事啊。
My wife came pick me up, and I saw the car was fine.
可是回家车，另外车没打开，另外一个车子停在车库里面。
When I went home, the other car was parked in the garage.
那个屁股真的被通通被撞进去了。
The car behind the car, everything was smashed in.
我跟他说什么时候发生的。
And I asked him when did this happen.
他跟我讲什么时候发生的。
And she told me when took place.
我说这么奇妙，就是圣灵告诉我的时间呢、啊。
And I said, how miraculous! That was exactly the same time that the Holy Spirit told me.
神保守，让他们母子都平安呢、啊。
God kept them safe.
那后来我们就去修车子。
Later, I took the car to the repair shop.
你们看过那辆烂车子吗？哈，我们一直开到这里的，最近才换。那辆车子呢？我想说，哎呀，这么烂了，不用去这个，不用去什么，反正 used part 拿来换一换就可以了。
I took it to the repair shop. Maybe you've seen that car. That was the van that I was driving, and because it was so old, I thought to myself, there's really no need to repair it.
用 used car 的 part 来那个旧车子的零件来换就好了。
Maybe we can just use some old car parts to just change it out.
后来车子修好了。
After they repair the car.
保险公司的这个钱也寄来了。
The insurance came with a bill.
我觉得哎，我还赚钱呢。
And I realized I even made money on that.
赚钱哎，这么多钱啊，送太太跟小孩回台湾一看，刚刚好哎。
And I made so much money that it was enough to send my wife and my son back to Taiwan.
因为其实我们早就想要送孩子回台湾一趟。
Because I wanted to send my son and my children back to Taiwan.
但是当时实在是没有钱了。
But back then, I really didn't have extra money to do that.
这个主耶稣啊，就是用这样的方法让我们赚钱的，真奇妙。
And God used this method, and so we had an extra money to do that.
所以家里的恩惠真的是谈不完。
So I cannot finish here telling you how much grace we receive in our family.
我们家的人也有时候会生病啊。
Sometimes my family members also get sick.
我们这里没有小朋友啊，小朋友有时候会生病啊。
My children will get sick.
那我们生病哦，就是有两条路，第一个就送医院，第二个就送教会。
So usually when they get sick, there are two ways we can take. One is to take them to the hospital or bring them to church.
我们都给主耶稣一个机会先啊。
We often will give God the first opportunity.
真的，常常孩子发烧，聚完会之后就没有发烧了。
Often when they're in fever, after service, their fever will be gone.
那我读神学院那段期间。
And during my theological school time,
我太太常常家里发生事情不告诉我。
Many times my wife would not tell me what happens at home.
这个回家才注意到说小孩子怎么头上一个包那么大。
And when I go home, I realize how come there's a bump on my child's head.
问他怎么一回事啊？
And I ask her what happened.
小孩子就跌倒，就撞一个洞啊。
It's because he fell and there was something knocked him and there's a hole.
我说有没有送急诊啊？
And I ask her to just took him to emergency.
他说没有啊。
And she said no.
现在怎么样了？
And what happens now?
反正就是自然愈合了，就是这样子了。
She will answer me. Now it's healing by itself.
很多时候就是这样子啊，就是主耶稣照顾了。
Many times it's like this. God will take care.
我们家的那个我的那个老大哈，其实他耳朵不是很好。
My daughter, she doesn't have very good listening.
那个。因为他常常有 allergy 嘛，所以鼻子跟耳朵都连在一起的。
Because she often she has allergy problems, so it affects her ability to listen.
上次跟童宁去，前几个月跟童宁去滑雪。
A couple weeks ago, she went skiing.
回家跟我们说，爸爸他耳朵流血了。
And when she came home, she told me, "How come my ear is bleeding?"
因为那个。一到这个山上啊，气压、啊，因为他说塞住啊，所以他出问题。
Because she was high up in the mountain, and due to the pressure, it caused her ear to bleed.
那是现在才了解，他的耳朵真的不是很好。
And that's till now that I realized that she doesn't have very
good ears. 这个问题小时候就有了。
Even though that problem existed,
那小时候不知道啊。
But I didn't know.
那小时候有时候晚上起来他就哭啊。
Because at night when she woke up,
she would start crying. 尤其我们 travel 经过山区的时候啊。
Especially when we travel to high mountains.
那哭怎么办呢？
And she cried, what should we do?
就是两条路啊。
There's only two ways.
祷告啊。
Pray.
或送急诊啊。
Or taking her to the hospital.
我们都选择第一条路啊。
And we often choose the first.
祷告完不哭了，不哭就好了，让她睡觉。
We pray and she stopped crying, then we'll leave her.
也是长得这么大了，现在。
And right now she's already this age.
我们就是让人戆戆戆戆安尼啊。我们都是这样笨笨笨笨啊，这样养也是这样大。
We just acted very innocently, and this is how we brought them up.
这个小孩子成长哦，是充满了神的恩惠。
In the growth of our children, we also see the abundant blessings of God.
有时候真的在神身上看到神爱我们的孩子。
And often on them, we see how much God loves my children.
我在我这个女儿选择学校大学，我也是从神上神主耶稣那边学到很多。
When my daughter was choosing which school to go to for her college, I also see how God blessed her.
她那个要考大学，这个高中毕业之后
，After graduating from high school,
我心里就想，最划算的就是先让她念 community college， 我省钱省最多。
I thought to myself that the best way to go is to let her go to community college first, and that would save at least 2 years of tuition.
可是哦，这个很难说服孩子嘞。
But it is very hard to convince my daughter.
他有上一些学校，你叫他念附近的学校，很难说服嘞。
It is very hard to convince her, especially when she was already accepted by different colleges.
我们也不敢说太多啊。
And we were not dare to tell her too much.
叫他祷告了。
We just told her to pray.
后来他真的愿意听话嘞。
But later she really listened to us.
我还问她说：“你怎么愿意走这条路的、啊？”
And I asked her, "How come you ended up doing to go into community college?"
她说：“哦，有三个很明显的记啊，主耶稣让我去的记号。”
And she said there were three very obvious signs that God showed me.
她说：“这个我在讲这个问题的时候，讲台就讲那个道理给我听了。”
First is when I thought about this problem, that was also the sermon that they were delivering.
我跟我女儿说，爸爸不是故意讲这种道理的哦，不是针对你讲的哦。
And I would tell her, my daughter, it was not intentionally, purposely to say it to you.
那两次啊，她祷告，祷告改变灵言呐，让她知道说神的意思就是让她走这条路。
And there were twice when her tongue changed during her prayer that made it obvious to her that God wanted her to take this way.
哦，所以我们真的也很感谢神。
So we really wanted to thank God.
但是人世间的事情也是很难说啦。
But it is very hard to predict.
你事后才看得出来。
It is afterwards that you realize.
他自己念了两年的社区大学。
After 2 years of community college.
他自己有很多的见证，他也知道。
She knows that she had many testimonies.
很多主耶稣额外的恩典呐。
There's very many additional blessings that God gave her.
后来两年之后要选学校。
2 years later, she was about to choose transfer.
有一个学校啊，那他说那个 deadline 已经过了，他不想申请了。
One of the schools, the deadline, she already passed the deadline, so she decided not to apply.
我说，哎呀，你就死马当活马医嘛，试试看呐。
And I told her, why don't you just still try, and we'll see what happens.
哦，爸爸，反正我上了，你也不会让我读啊，你那么省。
And then she told me that even if I get in, you won't let me go because, you save so much. You try to save so much.
那我说，哎呀，不知道，你反正你给我申请就对了。有时候我也是不太讲理的，你申请就对了。
So I just told her whatever the reason is, just apply.
她也是很乖，她要申请了。
So she did apply.
直到一天了，已经 deadline 已经过了。
Until one day,
deadline 已经过了，申请的 deadline 已经过了。
She already passed the application deadline.
后来那家学校真的上了呢。
But she got into that school.
上了变成我的烦恼了。
But then when she got in school, I started getting worried.
那些小学这么贵
？Because I thought to myself, that school is so expensive.
啊，另外一家是免费的。
And the other school she applied was basically free of tuition.
感谢主，他另外一家就是给他完全不用钱了。
Because thank to God, the other school gave her full scholarship.
所以一直心里想说，哎呀，怎么办呢？主耶稣愿意的话，给他选那个不用钱的。
And so I thought to myself, what should I do? If God is willing, let her choose the one that is full scholarship.
但是我不敢跟他讲嘞。
But I dare not tell her that.
因为这个总是不好意思跟女儿讲说啊，你不要去了，不要去了，太贵了啦。
Because it's very uneasy just tell my daughter don't go to that expensive one. Choose a
知道那个贵的学校哦，跟她拒绝奖学金之后，她拿那个那就到前面来哭，爸爸没有钱怎么去，就哭了。
When the school, the expensive school, sent her and rejected her scholarship application, she came to me carrying the letter and she started crying. And she said, Dad, what should I do? They decided not to give me any money.
哦，心就软了嘞。
And my heart softened.
哦，就打电话给我爸爸。
And I called my dad.
我说，老爸，你以前怎么那么勇敢呢？花那么多钱送我到美国留学。
I asked my father, how come you were so brave back then to send me?And spend so much money and send me here.
我今天要送我孩子上一个比较贵的学校，我都有点舍不得嘞。
Today, I was very unwilling to send my daughter to a more expensive school.
后来主耶稣也在这方面给我很多功课。
But God, taught me many things.
真的，我们对人生的这些钱财，有时候要从道理的角度再次审视一番。
What I learned is, in regards of money, we need to reconsider in terms from the perspective of the Bible.
真的是很奇妙了。
Miraculously.
后来我们决定就让她去读这间学校。
We decided later on to let her to attend the scholarship where she was rejected.
没有几个月，总会发一份公文下来。
A couple months later, GA sent us a letter.
传道的小孩协会补助一半。
The GA sent a letter and said that the General Assembly will assist half of the tuition from for the pastor's children.
哎，这个不是教会的钱哦，所以你们不要担心，这个是，这个是有一些同龄啊，他们特制的奉献呢。
The money that GA will be spending to assist the children of the pastors is not the offering that the members make. It's other money that some members dedicated to.
那时候我们就觉得，哎呀，神怎么这么爱人哦？真的有时候不知道怎么办。
And I thought, how come God loves men so much to the point that we don't know what we can do?
真的很感谢了，心中充满感谢。
I truly just have a full heart of thanksgiving.
我们家在孩子上面其实也是很多的问题。
Between me and my wife and our children, we also have our problems.
但是呢， 有时候在教导孩子上面也流了很多的眼泪。
And in terms of teaching my children, we also shed many tears.
有时候没播啦，不晓得怎么样教孩子啦。
And often comes the point we don't know what else we can do.
真的有时候不晓得怎么帮助他们。
We don't know what else we can do to help them.
那感谢主啦。
Thank to God.
不知道怎么办的时候，我们就祷告啊。
When we don't know what to do, then we'll pray.
后来啊，看到神渐渐的开路。
And we eventually saw how God opened up the road for us.
我们常常，我以前有个观念，就是从小只要在教会长大，孩子一定不会变坏。
Before I often have a thought that children that grew up in church, they will not turn bad.
现在我有不同的想法。
But right now, I have a different thought.
即使在教会长大，你不教还是会变坏。
Even though they're brought up at church, but if we don't teach them, then they will still turn to the wrong route.
如果你不教，你即使教没有神的恩惠，还是会变坏。
And even if you teach them, but there's no grace of God, then they will still be bad.
一个孩子可以正正常常的健健康康的成长，完完全全是神的恩惠，人没办法做什么。
For children to grow up healthy, it's entirely depending on the grace of God. There's not much man can do.
所以我们真的很感谢神。
We truly thank God.
有时候真的不晓得怎么办的时候。
Sometimes when we don't know what else we can do.
我们跪着祈求神。
We can only kneel and to request and plead to God.
看到神的带领。
To seek after His guidance.
看到神的带领。
And we will see His guidance.
所以我们真的是有时候觉得很战战兢兢呢。
So sometimes we live in fear.
不晓得怎么样来爱自己所爱的人，有时候。
We really sometimes don't know how to love the ones we love.
只能够常常为他们祷告。
Only we can pray for them.
主耶稣的恩典真的很多啊。
God's grace is indeed very abundant.
讲不完。
I won't be able to finish.
因为剩下几分钟了。
Because there's only a few minutes remaining.
我就讲到这里就好了。
I will stop here.
不然我再讲一件了。
I will continue. I would like to tell you just one more.
我们看一个经文。
Let's turn to a verse.
哥林多后书六章八节。
Second Corinthians.
哥林多书六章八节。
Second Corinthians chapter 6 verse 8.
六章八节。
Second Corinthians chapter 6 verse 8.
似乎忧愁，却是常常快乐的；似乎贫穷，却是叫许多人富足；似乎一无所有，却是样样都有。这是小弟当传道这几年的一个体会。
六章八节吗？
哥林多后书六章十节。
Chapter 6 verse 10.
请读。
Chapter 6 verse 10. Sorrowful, yet always rejoicing. Poor, yet making many rich. Having nothing, and yet possessing everything.
这是当传道这几年的体验。
And this is my reflection through this past few years.Few years being a pastor.
我刚传道的时候很不成熟了。
When I was first, when I first became a pastor, I was immature.
其实现在也不是很成熟了。
Even till now, I don't think I am mature yet.
很多观念还要学习。
I still have many things I need to learn.
我当传道的时候是很不甘愿的。
When I first became the pastor, I was unwilling.
因为我想说这个传道这个薪水太少了。
Because I thought to myself.Pastors, they really don't make much.
我知道很少，但是我不敢问啊。
I know they don't have a high salary, but I dare not ask how much they even make.
这个薪水花下来的时候，才知道哇，真的这么少，少原来的四倍。
When I got my first check, I realized it was so low. It was like four times lower than what I used to make.
那时候我们家真的很贫穷。
And back then, our living condition wasn't so good.
但是我觉得那个时候我们活得很快乐。
But yet we were joyful.
不晓得为什么。
Don't know why.
因为我从来不会烦恼钱的事情。
Because I never really worry about finance.
因为我当时当传道，我就是说，我就是很，我知道很穷，但是我 我知道我太太跟神一定有办法，交给我太太跟神去处理就好了。
Even though I know that we weren't living in very good conditions, but I knew that if things were entrusted to both God and my wife, then they will have a way.
我知道神一路一路带领啊。
And I realized that God guided us step by step.
好像什么都没有，却是什么都有。
Even though we have nothing, yet we have everything.
后来我妈妈，我被我妹妹怂恿啊。
I was encouraged by my sister.
我妈妈呢
？And my mother.
被我妹妹怂恿啊，
my,
被她劝动啊。
My mother was encouraged by my sister.
她说：“你这个在这个台湾那一块地哦，给人家做也没赚到一毛钱，你干脆把它卖了，来美国呢买一块买房子啊，我帮你收房租这样子。
”My sister told my mother that you have a piece of land in Taiwan, but no one is really using, and you don't get much rent from it. So why not sell that piece of land? Come here, buy a house, and then I will help you collect the rent.
啊，我妈妈后来真的听我妹妹的话。
And indeed, my mother listened to my sister.
啊，后来我去当传道了。
And then later, I went and became a pastor.
我妈妈突然有额外的收入啊。
My mother had additional income.
她就付我薪水了。
And then she would pay me rent. I mean, she would pay me.
所以教会如果给我一块钱，我妈妈就给我一块钱。
So if the church pays me $1, then my mom will match with $1.
所以，哎，这个是额外的恩典呢。
And this is additional blessing.
我妈妈说你应该感谢神，不要感谢我，因为这是神给我的。
And my mother would tell me that don't thank me, thank God, because this was given to me by God.
那个。啊，我都不管这些事情，反正按月领薪水就对了。
I really don't care much of how much I receive. I just get paycheck.
啊，几年之后
，every month, every month.
我的家人说要卖了，要把它卖了。
Within a couple years later, my family decided to sell the house.
啊，卖的时候要让我管理了。
And when they sell.
卖了之后，因为那是我的名字嘛，他就是要交给我管理这样子。
And after they sold the house because it was bought under my name, so they decided to
keep
in my sister's name. So they decided to give us the money, and so we can know how to manage it.
我发觉到我有那笔收入之后，哈，我晚上睡不着觉嘞。
But later than when I realized that I have that extra that amount of money, I couldn't fall asleep at night.
我说妈，你拿回去，这个太难了。
And I told my mother, why don't you take the money back?It is quite painful to have so much money.
我妈说不管你去处理。
My mom said, "I don't care. Just manage yourself."
哦，我觉得真的像传道说的，你有这个 diamond 之后就忘了老公了。
And indeed, just like the pastor say, a lot of times we have the diamond and we forget of the husband.
因为我没有处理过这样的一个事情啊。
Because I never manage such amount of money.
所以对我来讲也是造成困扰。
So to me, it actually caused me more trouble.
但是妈妈说要处理啊。
But my mother said I have to take care of it.
但是神也给我很多教导。
And but God taught me much.
也给我很多警告啊。
Actually gave me many warnings.
有一次我要到中国大陆去。
One time I was traveling to China.
为什么呢
？Why？
因为我妈妈叫我处理，我就拿一笔钱到中国大陆去买个东西啊。
Because my mother told me to manage this money, so I just took the money and bought something in China.
可是到年底或者说，我觉得我没有钱付税嘞。
But towards the end of the year, I realized that I don't have money to pay taxes.
我说税要付到七八万，我哪有钱付税付到七八万？
I realized that I have to pay about $70,000 to $80,000 of tax.And I don't have that money to pay that amount of tax.
我就跟老婆讲，老婆，我们去中国大陆拿钱呢。
And so I told my wife, why don't we probably get some money from from China, from mainland China?、
我们两个真的就去了。
So we flew there.
哦，啊，我去哦，主要是就不高兴嘞。
I flew there, and that made God very unhappy.
那个，我一上飞机就一直吐嘞。
Once I boarded on the plane, I started throwing up.
你知道那个飞机不是有那个吐的包包吗？
You know those throwing up bags that they provide you?
我吐了三包。
I threw up three bags.
我太太看到都不敢跟我坐在一起了。
I threw up to the point my wife didn't dare to get close to me.
我跟主耶稣讲，主耶稣，我以后不敢了。
And I told God I dare not to do it next time.
可是我下次会忘记的。
But then I often, you know, you tend to forget.
我有一些房地产在德州。
I have some properties in Texas.
那有一次总会说要到德州去开会。
And so one time, GA sent me to Texas to, they're holding some meetings there.
因为你知道 我不会处理，所以我买什么东西我都不看的，我就是东西送来我眼前我签一签，我连那个长得圆的扁的那个什么什么买什么东西长得圆的扁的我都不管的啦，反正只签一签我就丢了，我就是这样子啦。
I don't even know what I bought. I don't know what they look like. All I am in charge of is just signing the papers and just giving back the papers.
我想说，哎呀，要去那边开会，不然我提早一天去看一看到底买了什么东西啊。
And so I thought, since I'm going to Texas, why don't, maybe I should arrive there a day earlier and I can take a look at what I actually bought.
这样主耶稣也不高兴嘞。
But like this, God was also unhappy.
哦，我那天到机场去的时候。
That day when I was at the airport.
我在那个洗手间里面，我差点走不出来。
我
差点死在那里，真的。
I was in the bathroom and I almost died in the bathroom.
主耶稣不喜欢我提早一天去处理自己的事情嘞。
God did not like me to take an extra day of my time to take care of my stuff.
哦，我说得了两次教训了。
So I learned this, my lesson, throughout this time.
以后我就比较知道要怎么处理了啦。
And then in, later on, I realized and I learned how to take care of matters like this.
我太太最近跟我讲一句话。
Recently, my wife told me.
我最近。为什么我们现在到年底都要找钱？以前都不用这样，以前很穷的时候都不要这样子。
My wife asked me, how come every time right now during
到 tax season 的时候都要去找钱
？Now as we get close to the tax season, we always need to find extra money to pay taxes.
我说我也不知道啊，怎么办呢
？We never used to have to do this when even though we were poor.
但是就是学到很多了，现在我们还在学习，不晓得怎么办。
We're still learning. We don't know what we can do.
我们求主耶稣给我们那个正确的方向。
And we ask God to give us the right direction.
喜乐跟你的拥有不一定成正比的。
Joy and what you have it does not have an equal sign to it.
我在想，活着有主耶稣的恩惠，最重要。
Living and having the grace of God is the most important.
一切都交给神了。
And everything should be entrusted in
the hands of God. 但是我要说的一句话就是说。
But lastly, I would like to say,
我本来以为我当传道会变很穷。
I thought that being a pastor, I will be very poor.
但是可以不用这样子了。
But you don't have to be like this.
如果神要给人，谁都挡不住。
If God wants to give it to you, no man can stop.
但是如果人要这些求，不是神的意思，你怎么求也求不到。
But if we ask according to the will of man, no matter how hard you ask, you will not be
given. 所以圣经上讲，神赐给人富足是不加上忧虑的。
So the Bible says that God will give you wealth with no worries added to it.
愿一切尊贵荣耀归给神的名。
May all the glory be unto God's name.
感谢神。黄传道给我们做一个很感性的见证。
Thank God that Pastor Huang gave us a very good testimony.
虽然当中有一些沧桑，但是从他的见证里面，我们可以看到，可以听到很多的感恩。
Even though in his testimony we can hear some sadness, but we also hear the many blessings that he received.
刚才黄传道说，如果没有讲完的话，下次再讲。
Pastor Huang, in the very beginning, he said that if he doesn't finish his testimony, he will share with us next time.
所以我想，我们教务负责人可以再安排一次。
So, council members, you can probably take a different time to arrange Pastor Huang to testify.
传道见证有一个很大的帮助，就是他跟我们见证，他也给我们做了结论。
The good thing about asking a pastor to testify is after he will testify, and he will also make that conclusion for us.
所以我想我们每位弟兄姊妹都有很多的感触。
So I feel that brothers and sisters, we probably all had different reflections.
我们也听到我们要听的。
And we also heard what we needed to hear.
时间有点晚哈，那我们就延后十分钟好吗？因为我们晚餐的时间比较长一点。
Because there's some delay, then we will postpone the break time and we will start a little bit later, 10 minutes later.
请大家一起默祷。
Let's pray in silence.